Good morning and welcome back. So, yesterday I had a short stream where I was working on the pressure plate and the switch here, or button, for doors and secret doors you can open only with clicking buttons or pulling levers and stuff like that. Problem is that I need to think what kind of puzzles and stuff like that I want to have in my game. If I want more puzzles or more riddles, because most of the game's already dialogue based. If I want to go back from that and more to environment puzzles or stay on the dialogue idea and go more into riddles. And thank you for the hosts. That's a lot of unknown names and Unreal Engine. Thank you for the host. Must be that they rolled out a new feature that you host similar streams, meaning if you do any creative stuff, you host other creative streamers when you auto host, which is a bit strange. Yeah, that's the thing. Like I said, I need to figure this out and see what I can do there. Kind of tend more to the dialogue-based stuff, meaning riddles. And obstacles you can overcome by talking to people. So, not quite sure yet. But as soon as I'm starting the mine here, there might be something, some environment puzzles in there. And I also have secret doors in the underground area for the brewery over here, which is not really something you can see at the moment. These two doors here are secret doors and should only be opened by pulling a switch somewhere. But for that, I need to build the cave over here. And then fill out the area here. Let's see. I mean, it's the only quest we can finish at the moment, so let's go in here and fill out the area here a bit more and add some props, add some lights. Switch this to lit so that we can see the light here. And let's change my text. Let's do the brewery interior. Because the puzzles I need to figure out later. Puzzles and or riddles. Some light here, and let's remove this one. Copy this to the outside. And I need to remove this key. Oh no, let's keep the key there for the moment, but remove the light. And I need to build some kind of upper floor here. But the thing is that I need to completely rebuild the whole thing in Blender so I don't get these lighting errors here, because they are modular pieces, at least for the outside. And might also need to do that for the inside. Lights are separate. This piece shouldn't be separate. because all the other parts in here are not separate. Let's see. Do I have another candle? Wall lantern, wall lamp. No, I don't. So let's create a... let's copy this. Let's call it a standing candle. And let's put some lights on the tables. Light up here as well. Okay. Folder here. Yeah, no, I need to make the light a bit smaller on these. Because it's too much. Let's put the point light. Intensity, maybe half. And it's also a bit smaller. Thing is, the lighting needs to be rebuilt anyway in here, so makes sense. Let's see. Let's move all these into the right folder here. Also need a folder for doors. Yeah, okay, the town and I need to work on. Something I want to change here because the tables, benches and stuff like that, I want to have separate from the base geometry. Proper name. Door. Brewery kitchen. Need at the moment, I think. Okay, I think I know why the doors here do not work properly. Let's detach that door. around, or yeah, this is just a test. We don't need that. Yeah, it's okay. And we also don't need the switch and pressure plate. Why is that static mesh actor? Oh yeah, I put them there just to check if there's a difference between the foliage and the rest, but there isn't. What is this? Okay, let's group them. I only needed that to move them. Okay. Let's go back to the brewery. Tables in here, I want to have separate. Let's see. Let's convert those to. Thank you for the follow. Okay, that's not what I wanted. Selected items here. one, and yeah, there we go. Okay. As a result, they do not, they're not lit correctly, but I need to redo the lighting anyway. So all these here, our benches, convert to instance. I really like this plugin. It's called the Instance Tool, and you can convert instances and static meshes to instances and stuff like that. And really helps to keep the amount of static meshes you use down, because instance static meshes only use one draw call. No. The tables and chairs and stuff like that are part of a model pack I bought, and basically all the wooden parts here. The walls and the outside here that I did, those I did myself. But I haven't changed the tables and interior props yet. I'm still using stuff from an asset pack I bought. But it's not an asset pack for Unreal, but for Unity, because I started the project in Unity. And these round tables have a small issue I need to fix at some point. They are not really round, and I want to change the shape of them at some point as well. So I basically want to recreate them on my own at some point, but the moment I'm just using these as placeholders. I'm from Germany. Is it the accent? I'm not sure. most people guess the accent and I'm not sure, but it doesn't matter where I'm from. Okay. Next thing would be this. Counter. One of those. There is no downside. The thing is, okay, yes, there's one downside. For instanced meshes, you have only one material. So if you want to have different materials on different meshes, you need to use static meshes. Or not instanced static meshes, but single static meshes. But if you use a lot of the same mesh in your level, then you use pro you do draw call for each of them. And if you use instances or instant static meshes, you only use one draw call for the whole thing and not for each instance. Kind of depends on what you want to do. If they have texture that looks good, material that it's okay, that all of them should have, it's better to use instances. If you use a lot of them, but if you want to have want your mesh to have different materials, different material instances and stuff like that, it's better to use normal static meshes. In my case, I want the original material for the mesh for all of them, and as a result I can, it's better to use instances. There are a few ways where you can change the material, but so far I haven't figured it out how to do it properly. But if it's the same material, then you should be fine. If they are static meshes, then yes. If they are blueprints, then no. Because blueprints do not work the same way. For instance, if you're doing a tower defense game or stuff like that, then it wouldn't work that way. But if they are just static meshes, then yes, go for it. Let's change this to so I can see the wall better. Okay. One problem with this texture here is that it's not really tiling that nicely. Here, that's another thing I need to change about those. I mean, it doesn't really matter, but it looks a bit strange here. That's why I said I need to change a few of the textures here. Yeah, the I don't want to do anything about this gap here because I might completely create a proper stair mesh and stuff like that in Blender. What happened? Okay, this is the kitchen, so we need some tables here where we can prepare food. Let's put two of them here. Also need some furnaces of some kind, so let's see. Meshes, props, kitchen. Okay. Yeah, practice. Practice makes better. Yeah. But if you want to ask questions in German, it's no problem. You can do that. I might answer them in English when if there, if the answer would be useful for other people, but move those up here. Instances. Okay, that's fine. Okay. This is already using the material I worked a bit on. So it's glowing. So if we put this to lit, then they will glow in the dark and get a bit of bloom as a result. Oh, when did I start? I mean, I started working in Unreal 4 on this project last October, but I have done a bit in Unreal before that. Let's see. Yeah, I can't really find out when I started this project here, but it was in 4.9. And then I worked a bit on it. So, but I took a break for about a year or so, or a bit longer, not doing anything in Unreal. So I kind of had to relearn in October last year. But before that, I worked on projects in Unity and one project in Unreal Engine 3, UDK, a student project. So it's not completely new, it wasn't completely new to me. The thing is, it at the moment it's something in between. I'm not really earning money with it, but I'm working on a game that I want to sell. It's really awesome. And the thing is, I'm on their list of auto hosts because I'm using Unreal, and I have the hashtag UE4 in my title. So it's not the first time they are hosting me. Thank you for the host, Kitco. Kitku. Do I need in here? Shelves. I definitely need shelves. And maybe some pans and pots. Yeah, but these I definitely need to work on because all the metal pieces I need to work on because the asset pack I use isn't PBR, isn't using PBR textures, and I need to change that. Materials. Hello, how are you? Shelves. Cupboards. Let's change the name here. Let's move that over here to clutter. Because here I only have the walls and big elements in here, and not the small furniture. Props I have in that would be in here. So somewhere here. Let's see. Lighting, light props. Yeah, one thing I haven't figured out yet is the I went to a school for game design and game programming, but I wouldn't say that I learned all this at that school. It's a mixture of both. I mean, I'm a certified game designer and certified game programmer, but I haven't worked in the game industry yet, so that doesn't mean anything. Yes, I went to a school, I learned some interesting basics, but I never really had the chance to work on a complete published game project. I had a few student projects and small other projects, and you can look at my blog that I just linked there for projects I worked on. Even though there are two projects I worked on that are not mentioned anywhere, but but the problem is that I can't talk about those projects. I mean, I could talk about them by now, but doesn't really matter because they were cancelled. What school did you do you go to? I mean, if you can say that, sure, maybe. Oh, okay. Yeah, I went to the Games Academy in Berlin. move the open crates. And here we have another thing that I want to change, because looks a bit strange, that picture here, and doesn't really fit to the rest. So I need to change those textures to something else. So we have a bit of lighting here, a few props. And in here I want to put brewery vats, means I need to put some cylinders in here just as placeholders. Let's make them 4x4. Damn it. Let's make 3 copies. Them in Y by 300. No, 300 was enough. Let's undo that. Let's make this 500. Could add one more. Yeah, let's do that. Let's move it away from the wall here a bit. big copper cylinders here. But to lead the player down there. And also light the steps a bit better. And the only important thing in here is this barrel. The rest is not important. So we don't need to light more candles in here. And I might just add one of them on the other side. Just to give the room a bit of lighting. And these two doorways here are secret doors, which I need to close off. Be this one. We need, and we also need the doorway here, which would be a wall. No, we don't need that place this properly here. This we need to change because this one is supposed to be a puzzle element. No, door secret. Select that door again. And these are blueprints, so they are not instanced. To the right folder here. Let's give them proper names. Thank you. And have fun. Goes to the laboratory here, or secret room. But I don't want to connect anything here yet. Though let's see, maybe puzzle element, switch actor. Loose stone in here somewhere. That I can use as a switch. This could work. Wrong kind of stone. Yeah, it's really hard to see that, which is kind of a good thing as well. Let's see, can we play from here? Yeah. Okay, you can see this. So if it's lit, then can see it. So let's here. But I think I want to move it somewhere else. Not directly next to the door that it will open. Somewhere over here. Okay. And the next thing I want to have in there is, let's see, we need a folder for that. Let's create a top level folder here and call this puzzles. And then where it is and what it is for. Fell through the floor and again. Start up here. Let's see, we need to start in here because I don't have the key. It looks okay. There might be a bit more lighting needed in here, but the rest is okay. This here, which you can barely see, and that opened this door. But there's nothing behind it yet, which means I need to build the cave down there. And in the cave, there will be a switch to open this door. And behind that door, you will find a chest. And in that chest is the recipe you are sent to retrieve from this brewery. The main quest, basically. But it's locked between two doors. And the other thing is, you start on the other side of the map. Don't know where the brewery is in the beginning. Okay. So let's add the corner pieces here to make this look a bit better. Counter is that? That's counter one. instance. This one. And again, I need to rebuild those so that they fit a bit better. But they're good for placeholders. Back top of the counter. Let's have a look. Okay, I removed the light here, but left the key. Let's move the key somewhere else where we can actually see it. Yeah, you might be able to see that key over here. And I will remove it later, it's just to test. Oh, because the there's a box collider on the counter. That's why the key couldn't lie there. Need to change the collisions. Like I said, I wanted to rebuild it anyway, so. Here we have the key, and now we can equip that. And unlock the door. Yeah, the walls are a bit too shiny. I need to change that. Like I said, I need to rebuild the walls anyway, so. Not that big a deal at the moment. Here we can pick up the air barrel, so that's okay. So I will be right back, and then we will continue working on the interior. Okay, I'm back. Sorry about that. So, let's see. What else can we do here? Toilet doors here. And yes, those are supposed to be toilets. Test those doors. And we also need a light next to that. It's not locked, and this would be an interior heavy door. Let's copy this one. That's kitchen two. Doors. No, I don't think. No, I will not add doors here. I think that's okay. And the upper floors I need to figure out, because of the roof and stuff like that. Okay, let's see. I mean, I could add a bit more clutter in here, but not really at that stage yet. I want to add that. It's more of the level layout and stuff like that at the moment. That's more important. And the top floor, like I said, depends on what I want to build here, which I'm not sure yet. And thank you for the follow. So, I think that's good for the first pass of the interior here, so that you have something that you can walk along. And because the first thing you want to do in here is get down to the basement and grab that barrel, because it's one of the quests. Yeah, when I change the roof, then there will be closed roof here. So we could throw in some chandeliers here, let's see. Even though the lighting at the moment should be enough. Change that. Standing candle, I also need to move them. That two more and then position the light in the middle of all of them. Make it a bit bigger. Gently here. Yeah, I think that's okay. This over here. At the moment they are floating, but like I said, there will be a roof on top of them when I change the exterior walls here, which I might not do today. Definitely not in the morning stream because I'm nearly out of time. Yeah, it looks a bit strange that this is lit from the underside and casting shadows that way. Okay, the key is completely gone now. Not good. Monsters? Not sure what you mean. Definitely need to redo, rebuild the lighting and fix the walls. Not much because I missed another week because I was ill. Yeah, but I want to change the wall textures and stuff like that because I'm not that happy with them. So that might change a bit. But the thing is, I'm still trying to figure out the art style, which might change a bit. Sunlight region here. And I need to change the door textures here because it's mirrored and you can see the mirror. I don't want that. Okay. Yeah, the sun reaches in here. That's good. Even though it's kind of ignoring the color of the windows, but I'm not sure if I can set this. Hello. I'm fine, thank you. looks like the chairs are floating, but I'm not sure. I don't think they do. Might not get light coming through the doorway here, just from the angle this brewery is in. But the windows work, so that's good. And the light here is from that hole. It will not be there once I kind of rebuilt this in Blender. And I also need to figure out the other buildings around here at some point. Chandeliers in the right folder here. Few more minutes. So let's do a bit of sorting out here. Your new folder, doors, so I can remove those doors out here. Control door and trap door. these saving. The rest in here should all be building stuff, even though we don't need the floor pieces here anymore. We still have references to that, but that's okay. Because the buildings, they're in I will completely redo, so it's okay to delete them. Okay, so I am not 100% sure if I will be back this evening because I have a dentist appointment and I'm not sure if he has to do something, if I can speak properly after that and so on. So I will tweet out if I will do an evening stream today. But tomorrow I should be back for an afternoon stream. Which means I need to change the schedule information on the page. And because Tuesdays and Thursdays I want to change to afternoon streams, which will be one big block of 8 to 6 hours in the afternoon. And ending at the Unreal Engine streams. So it will be a different schedule. But I will change the information for that so that it's not confusing. Okay, so I think that's all for the morning stream today. Like I said, I'm not quite sure if I'm doing evening stream today, but if everything works according to plan, I will be back this evening. Otherwise, I will tweet out that I'm not doing a stream. Or you can read the message here on the page. So, bye bye. See you guys later.